Unfolding the eternal excellences, the hidden insights of the truth, and the depth of the riches of wisdom and knowledge.
The Bible says, I have cleansed thee by the word. I have not pointed to your weaknesses. He says, I have cleansed thee by the word. I have pointed to your strength. And this is your strength, that I am Christ in you, the hope of glory.
The glory of freedom, the glimpses into eternity.
The gospel is not supposed to be an assumption. It's not supposed to be just a mere presupposition. Truth is older than language, but the word of God is way deeper than any human language.
And now, Apostle Grace with the Word.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
I don't want to watch you, hallelujah. Today I want to preach a message
about a man.
A
man.
A
great man.
The
Bible says in Daniel chapter 9.
Bible was the book by Daniel
verses 26.
It
says, and after 72 weeks shall the Messiah be cut off. The Messiah shall be killed. The Messiah will be annihilated. His life will cease by wicked men. But the Bible says,
and the Bible watch it,
but not for himself. Not for himself. He said the Messiah shall be cut off. But not for himself. He says that the Messiah shall be killed. But not for himself. He said he shall die. And bring the life out of himself. By the hand of certain men. But the Bible says.
And the Bible watch it.
But not for himself.
I come to talk about a man.
That did not come for himself. Tell your neighbor we are talking about a man. That did not come for himself. That did not live for himself. That did not die for himself. That did not exist for himself. Somebody shout amen. Shout hallelujah. Thousands of years ago, the angel of the Lord appeared unto a woman which was a virgin and brought her glad tidings that God has something to put in the inside of your life. And he said, and that thing shall be of the Holy Ghost. And he was a son.
And not here what?
The Bible says of God.
What part of God?
Bible, and he says, and ye shall call him Jesus. And
the
virgin woman which knew no man.
Said,
how shall it be?
What it were in
seeing that I know no man. And
he
says, this thing shall be done by the Holy Spirit. She received the instruction of God and said yes to a divine experience. And she bore a child. His name was Jesus. The Bible says that he was like any other child. He was not born in the best hospital in the world. He was not born under the best care in the world. The Bible says that he was born in a manger. The parents did not even have an inn to put him in. He was born next to animals. And he was raised an average man. But even though outwardly he was an average man, inwardly there was a wonder-working power of God. Of a life of God. Building in this young man. The Bible tells us he grew up in wisdom.
The Bible, what you doing here?
And stature. And in favor with God and man. The scriptures give us accounts.
Bible, what you are
of the prophetic words that were spoken on his life.
The scripture that I just read in Daniel chapter 9
Bible, Daniel
was an experience that was spoken of a young man
that
was due to walk the surface of this earth. And a prophetic word came out and said, he shall be killed, but not for himself. That is a disturbing testimony to speak of another man's son. But that was the testimony touching this man. The prophet Isaiah continues to speak of this man in Isaiah chapter 53 verses 2. He said he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of a dry ground. This man has no form, no comeliness. When we shall see him,
how have been there?
The Bible says, he says there is no beauty that we should desire of him.
Bible, what you put in link more been there? Okay, come up for it.
Jesus was not handsome.
Yet you know, play
like some movies show him.
You know, that video we can in Europe.
And the Bible says, consider yourselves brethren.
Bible, why you tell him?
Touching your calling.
Manope.
He says, not many of you are wise.
Man, will not pull
after the flesh. Not many of you are mighty. After the flesh. Not many of you are noble. After the flesh. But God called you. He does the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. And the Bible says that he has chosen the weak things of this world to confound the things that are mighty. The man that gathers us here today have nothing to admire on him. There was no desire for him. There was no look on him that would cause anyone to admire him. But inside that man was a treasure in
unearthly
wealth, and the excellence of power was God. Verse 3 says, he was despised. He was rejected of men. The Bible says he was a man of sorrows. And he was acquainted with grief. And the Bible says, and men hid their faces from him because he was despised. He was rejected. Men looked there and saw him and looked away. Some people think that being born again is foolish. They think being born again is stupid. They think being born again is foolish. They think what we are doing here is a wastage of time because we represent the same man. The Bible says we esteemed him not. But the man whom we did not esteem, surely, the Bible says, surely,
of the Bible word,
that man bore our griefs and carried our sorrows. But while he carried the sicknesses, while he carried our sorrows, while he carried our griefs, because we rejected him, we despised him, there was nothing beauty to desire of him. He was to be killed and cut off. The Bible says, that we esteemed him smitten of God and afflicted. That man was wounded for our transgression. That man was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. With his stripes we were healed. I said, with his stripes we were healed. Because God saw like we were sheep that had gone astray. This man on their way. And the Lord laid on him in the state of his rejection all our iniquity. Everything ugly with us. Everything despicable with us. Everything unpleasing with us. Everything sinful with us. The same man carried. I pity the woman who saw her son go through all of this. Verse 7, he was oppressed. He was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, as a sheep before his shearers. And he opens not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment. He was cut off out of the land of the living, like Daniel had prophesied. For the transgression of his people, that man was stricken. Verse 9 says he made his grave with the wicked. And with the rich in his death. And yet he had done no violence. Neither was any deceit in his mouth. Tell your neighbor, a man lived one day. And when he was teaching, he told the people he met in Matthew chapter 20:28, he said, in spite of all of this, I did not come to be ministered to, but I came to minister. And he said, and I came to give my life for a ransom of many. For no greater love has no man than this, than a man should lay down his life for his friend. John says in 15:13, that man came to do that. And he endured the cross. Philippians 2:7 says, he made himself of no reputation. And put upon him the form of a servant. And came in the likeness of men. And the Bible says, and being humble and found in the fashion of a man, he humbled himself even as unto the cross, for the propitiation of our sins, for our offenses, for our iniquities. Yet he knew no sin. He felt rejected. He felt despised. We thought God was punishing him. Yet the bigger picture, that man was doing something for the world. And then he went on the cross. He shed his blood at Calvary.
Oh God,
he died for your sins and mine. And he carried our infirmities. He bore our sicknesses. He carried our pain. He said mankind should not suffer. Every pain you were to carry, he carried it. Every sickness you were to carry, he carried it. Every sorrow you were to carry, he carried it. Every despise you were to get, he was despised. Every rejection you were to carry, he carried it. And the Bible says, because of that, God highly exalted him and gave him a name which is above every name, that at the name of that man every knee should bow, not will bow, not might bow, not could bow, not will bow. He says every knee should bow of things in heaven, of things on the earth, and of the things in the earth. He says, and every tongue should, not might, not will, not could. He said every tongue should confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of the Father. Whether in hell or in heaven, one day every tongue will confess that that man is Lord, to the glory of the Father. Whether in fire or in paradise, one day every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that that man is Lord, to the glory of the Father. Cancer bows, HIV bows, all sicknesses bow, witchcraft bows, all infirmities bow,
of that name. There is no name under the earth by which men are saved but the name of Jesus. That name cures cancer. That name saves your soul. That man changes anything. That man levels mountains. That man flattens valleys. That man changes situations. That man rewrites stories. That man changes history. Somebody shout amen.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Glory to God.
Hey, Baba.
His birth.
Your life
brought us life.
Okay, look,
his life.
What?
Gave us salvation.
I mean, what
his wounds.
Healed
our body. His shame.
Look at
brought us glory. His weakness became our strength. His poverty became our wealth. His chastisement became our peace. His righteousness became our gift. His death gave us life. He is love. He is wisdom. He is redemption. He is sanctification. He is hope. He is life. He is joy. He is hope. He is power. He is an answer. Our shepherd. Our defender. Our redeemer. Our vision. Our assignment. Our destiny. Our redeemer. Our ever-present help. In time of need. Our morning star. Our foundation. The beginning. And the end. The Alpha, the
Omega,
the first, and last, the author, and the finisher of our faith, the glory, and lifter of our heads, the friend that sticks closer than a brother, the bread of heaven, the Prince of Peace, the Son of Righteousness, the Rose of Sharon, the Lion of Judah, the Rock of Ages, the lamp of our feet, the light of our path, the spring of our life, the essence of days, the darling of heaven, our banner, our comforter, our friend, our brother, our victory, our triumph. The Bible says he became all things. He is the fullness
and
that filleth all things. He is the express image of the invisible God. The world exists before me. Nothing that was made is made without him. For in him was life. Life was the light of men. And that light shines in darkness. And darkness comprehended him not. And God anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power. And he went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. For God was with him. Somebody shout amen. Hebrews 11:32 says, and what more shall we say? For the time would fail me to tell of men that believed him, of men that walked with him. Gideon,
Barak,
Samson,
Paul,
Elijah,
Jeremiah,
Apostle Grace. Put your name. Put your name. David. Samuel. The prophets. The apostles. The teachers. The evangelists. The church. On Solomon's porch. That has changed destiny. And rewritten history. Somebody shout
hallelujah.
And the Bible says. These through faith subdued kingdoms.
And they are in the year.
They wrote
right.
They obtained promises. They stopped the mouths of lions. They quenched the violence of fire. They escaped the edge of the sword. Out of weakness, they were made strong. They waxed valiant in fight. They turned to flight. The armies of their enemies.
Mort
received their dead.
Bujolo jogi muto.
Somebody said hallelujah.
Naramalo danga hallelujah.
And some were tortured.
Singaramalo kijja.
Some were killed.
Mukene kinego.
Some were persecuted.
Him kigoyogi.
Some were stoned.
Kiki chanyogi.
Some were sawn asunder.
Jano kibayogi dead.
Some were tempted.
Kino kimaoge.
Some were slain.
Kinegogi.
Some wandered around.
Mukene
kuberku. Some were destitute.
Mukene no kitiga.
Some were tormented.
Kino lugu kitiyogi alada.
But they all believed this man.
Ento kengu ye komla chon. Dang amen.
He is the only one.
And kikan.
That can change your life.
Maramola kukwone.
I said he is the only one.
Awachi and kikan.
That you need.
Ma yini miro.
Witchcraft won't save you.
Tiet populari.
That man will save you.
Lachon bulari.
If the Bible was fake.
Kono Bible timki antata.
It would not be the top selling book every year.
Uno peperu book maki wilu loy wenki wilobo.
Fiction never sells that way.
I have good news for you.
That man can change your life.
Somebody
say, Jesus! Tonight, you change my destiny. That is the man. That is the man that lit this stadium this evening. That is the man healing the sick. That is the man cleansing the leper. That is the man opening the blind eyes. We must decrease. And he must increase. Somebody shout amen. Gulu has been remembered.
Gulu
with a bad past. Konyi came.
Konyo Piro.
And did his things in the north of Uganda. And people came.
Sindano Piro.
To deal with the atrocities.
Of
Konyi.
And
his people.
Kijone.
But Gulu.
Gulu.
The time has come.
Karo.
For men to fly here.
Men
to see your God.
Men no
the time has come.
Karo, Piro.
For men to get flight.
Fesio,
to come and heal.
Men, Piro,
the time has come.
Karo, Piro.
For men to come to Gulu.
Fesio, bin, Gulu.
To receive deliverance.
Men, konyo, konyo.
The time has come.
Karo, Piro.
For Gulu to become a town.
Men, Gulu, do,
for Gulu to become one of the most prosperous cities.
Men, Gulu, be,
in the world. The time has come.
Karo.
For Gulu to lead the world.
Men, Gulu, be,
the enemy intended for God, our God will turn into good. Only madmen throw stones on trees without mangoes.
Konyi
knew why he was touching the northern
Uganda.
He knew the spirit that is in northern
Uganda.
And I have good news for you. That spirit has outlived corn. It will outlive HIV. It will outlive cancer. It will outlive death. It will outlive poverty. It will outlive any other thing. We can only do it through one man. Who is that man? Who is that man? Give somebody a high five and tell him I love.
I don't think the more can you.
Jesus.
What he gets you.
Saralabaya. Now I want you to take only 15 seconds.
I'm here to tell you that you're a second apart, but you can.
And celebrate that name.
Take
15
seconds.
I want the whole of Gulu
to
hear the voices that are coming from here. Take some seconds and just celebrate that man. 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 That is for you, Jesus. That's for you. Somebody shout amen. Shout glory to God. That man is here. And he's going to do something. He's healing the sick now. He's cleansing the leper now. He's doing miracles now. I want you to open your heart. And talk to that man up there.
She looked for the John and only.
And that man who is in you.
That's your matter.
He is in your heart.
Anti Chuji.
As a believer.
Machala Yeo.
But he's seated with the Father in the heavenly places also.
Don't be the day by one waki come.
I want you to raise your voice.
I made a heal 20 miles.
With a heart of prayer.
Kitchen Melega.
And pray right now.
She legge combated
for a miracle.
The town.
In that name.
In Yingan on the Hill Chimalo.
Just open your voice and pray.
You have 20 kunilek bon lupa.
Pray like you have never prayed before.
Lege chalo pia managa ya lego.
Just open your mouth.
I have dugi kunilok kilupa.
He's moving.
Enter what?
He's moving.
Enter what?
He's moving.
Enter what?
Open your voice and pray.
You have 20 chilege.
Call out on that name.
Wrong yingan on it.
Call upon him.
Wrong yingan.
Tell him Jesus saved me.
What do you do, Lord?
Jesus healed me.
Get you job.
Jesus changed me.
Get you, Lord.
Jesus reveal yourself to me.
Get you, Lord. What a rocket.
Come on, open your mouth.
Yap doge. Yap doge look kilo ba.
Pray.
Lege. Lege, lege, lege.
Pray.
Lege.
Rapa talabaya.
Lege bolo ba,
Jire lele.
Lege bolo ba. Il tigu ni
karababa
le boloba Juan
Carraba soro bobobo
sa le boloba
roba sakarala la
boloba inera batien.
Open your mouth.
Yap doge.
Open your mouth.
Yap doge.
Come on, the Spirit of God is here.
Chin boloba tikan.
The Spirit of God is here.
Chin boloba tikan.
Open your mouth.
Yap doge.
Open your mouth.
Yap doge.
Open your mouth.
Yap doge.
At the center of it all, it's you that I see. It's you that I see. Open your mouth.
Yap doge.
At the center of it all, it's you that I see. It's you that I see. There is power with your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift the voice to pray, it's you that I see. It's you that I see. There is power within your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift the voice to sing, it's you that I see. It's you that I see. Help me quiet, tell him there is power in your name. Oh, miracles happen in your name.
Miracles happen in your name.
Oh. As we lift the voice to pray, it's you that I see. What do you see? It's you that I see. Oh,
boasting all the time. There is power in your name. Miracle happen in your name. As we lift our voice to pray, it's you that I see, it's you that I see. You were bigger, you were stronger, you were higher, you were greater. Oh, you are bigger, you are stronger, you are higher, you are greater. Hey, you are bigger. Oh, you are stronger. Oh, you are higher. The power of God is moving. The power of God is moving. I want you to touch where your pain is. Bring those that are slain here. Carry them here. If you're sick in your body, I want you to touch where that pain is. If you're crippled, touch that leg. If you have a fibroid, I want you to touch it. If you have a swelling, I want you to touch it. Right now in the name of Jesus, I rebuke that spirit of infirmity and disease. Cancer. Loose. Fibroid. Swelling. Loose. Somebody came deaf in the ear. Deafness. Loose. Someone came dumb. They could not speak. You dumb spirit. Loose. Somebody came blind. Your eye could not see. You spirit of blindness. Loose. Heart disease. Loose. Diabetes. Loose. HIV. Loose. All disease. In the name of Jesus, I command you to loose. Headaches.
About which?
Loose. There's somebody with a spirit of madness. There's a young girl. She has been struggling with the spirit of madness. The power of God is coming where you are. There's another young man as well. You've been on drugs. The spirit of madness, we command it to loose. Power
out.
Those of you that feel you are healed, you came with a pain and it has healed. You came with a crippledness. You are healed. You came with a swelling on your neck, in your stomach, on your body, and it has healed. You came with a pain in the stomach, it was swollen, and it is healed. Run here. Run here. Somebody came with a back pain. Your back could not
not move. God is healing you now. Somebody came with a pain in your leg. You could not bend your leg. God is healing you now. So anybody who is healed, run here. Run here. Run here. All of those that are healed, bring them here. Somebody's healed. Give her crutches. Lift them and ashamed the devil. Put them up. Walk.
Worry.
Walk.
Worry.
Put them up.
Ilmalo.
That is Jesus. That is Jesus. That is Jesus. That is the man. That is the man. There's another one there. Walk.
Water.
That is the man. Put up your stick. That is the man. Walk.
Water.
That is the man. That is the man. That is the man. There's another one. Let them hold their sticks. Come running. Come. Come. That is the man. That is the man. That is the man. Somebody give him a mighty hand of a praise. Give him a mighty hand of a praise. You put it up. Walk with your stick.
What?
I want all of the cripples to walk. Walk. Baba. Put up your stick.
He'll do.
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 That is the man.
He'll do.
That is the man I'm talking about. That is the man I'm talking about. That was the one. That is Jesus. Somebody give him a mighty hand of a praise. Give him a mighty hand of a praise. Oh, there is power in your name.
There is power.
He's still healing.
Yeah, Jago.
Miracles happen in your name. Tell him as we lift our voice to pray. Voice to pray. It's you that I see. Oh. There's another one.
Who can I jump?
There's another one.
Who can I jump?
He's running.
Yeah, wait.
There's another one.
Who can I jump?
There's another one.
Who can I jump?
That is Jesus. That is Jesus. Miracles are happening. Everywhere. That is Jesus. That is Jesus. That is Jesus. That is Jesus. There's another one.
Who can I jump?
There's another one.
Who can I jump?
That is Jesus. That is Jesus. That is Jesus. That is Jesus. Somebody give the Lord a man a cup of praise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen.
We
God is still healing. He's still delivering. I want to hear testimony. This lady had a swelling in her stomach. Swelling in her stomach for how long?
For 1 year.
It is gone. Wow. Somebody give the Lord a man of a praise. Help mama go.
This lady got an accident.
And
was broken. She's totally healed.
And no,
put it up. Put up your sticks. Can you run? Run for me. Run for me.
Hey!
You could not move without your stick. Somebody said
amen.
Yes,
next lady has had back pain for 1 year. It's totally gone.
You cannot bend.
Now she
can bend. Miracle testimony, quickly.
She had pain in the right leg.
She could not walk. That was where the swelling was. Now you're healed. God bless you, mama.
The pain on this leg, it died on its own. Now it's totally gone.
Somebody give the Lord a man of praise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This lady was unable to walk for 3 years.
3 years. 3 years. Ladies and gentlemen, 3 years.
And she's ready now to throw all her sticks away.
And don't get terrible. Tell mama to walk.
What the mama worry,
oh my God.
Somebody give the Lord a man of God praise.
This gentleman had a compound fracture for 2 years. He could not walk without a stick. Now he can walk without a stick.
Hallelujah. Somebody give the Lord a man of praise.
Amen. Don't think me pack ball over.
Got an accident on the 24th of December.
24th
of December. Uh-huh. He's totally healed now. He can walk without a stick.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. This lady had back pain. Now it's healed.
Totally.
How long has it been?
9 years.
9 years. You're free. I decree that you're free. And sickness will never be a part of your story. In Jesus' name.
Huh?
This lady had had hip pain for 3 years. And now she can bend.
Tell her to put up her stick. Mama, you do malo. You do malo. Tell her to bend.
Watch it. Go, 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 mama. Go. Go.
She couldn't bend.
Oh. And she couldn't walk without the stick. Tell her
mama.
Not to use that stick again.
Mama,
don't use it again. You are healed. God bless you,
mama.
This gentleman had a back pain. He's totally healed.
A woman not how long? What you want to become a Roman? It was last year. I got an accident. And my backbone got out. I've been taking medication. And it has gone.
Bend.
Bend. Bend.
Somebody give the Lord a man of God praise.
Yes,
this lady, she's been bleeding for 2 weeks. She feels the bleeding has
stopped.
I want to hear another one. This lady has been mad for 3 years. 3 years. This is the sister.
Wait. She has been mad for
3 years. Yes.
She came mad.
Yeah.
Now she understands.
She understands now.
A woman has been mad for 3 years. 3 years. What's her name?
I'm calling Judge Dorothy.
Judge Dorothy.
You're feeling better now?
Yes.
What happened when I was praying? What did you feel when I was praying?
The spirit came inside me. And I fell down. I
started
crawling
down.
From there I was crying. I said, God heal me.
He has healed you. 3 years of madness. May God fix every mad situation in your life. I said, may God fix every mad situation in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes.
This lady got an accident 2 years ago. And she couldn't walk without this stick.
Oh, somebody give the Lord a man of God praise. Yes.
This lady has had a headache for 5 years.
Are you guys hearing this?
What
are you
looking?
Headache for how many years?
5 years.
Yes.
This lady has had pain for 3 months on her knees.
And
she's healed. Yes,
glory to God.
Next. 2 good years. Breathing was hard. And now last night the heart area here was pain so much. This time as we were praying, I felt something good pouring upon me and in my stomach. Something God is doing for me. I feel I can breathe.
You are not breathing.
It's so hard for me to breathe.
No, text to
all
me you.
Thought that maybe I do not want to do something. That breathing was
no, get down in parameter again. You ain't not the
God.
Boil
this is
good.
Wangario, pero mo yueyo eto tin ke lego pire. Lo ba kia e romo yueyo mabe. Lugulu do tingu polo ba. Mini chama lo ba tia tiune.
This lady has had pressure for 4 months and her legs were heavy.
Ah, la mega ne opero ke kuara tiene. Tiene no pe.
Right now, she's totally free.
Heavy or swollen?
Swollen.
They were swollen.
Swollen, yeah, and painful.
No, now they've gone back.
Udoko tiene kumbene. Oh, John, no, you're the
chingo back. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Normal dang hallelujah.
This lady has had arthritis.
Ah, a remedy.
And she's healed. She's healed.
Ke kengure. Ke chie.
This is the husband.
Eno virtuare. My hands were swollen
for 1 year.
For 1 year. All the hands are healed. This hand.
Oh, she came with swollen hand.
Yes. She could not do that. She could not even walk.
Not at all touching anything, even cooking.
Pero wa tero, pero wa kutukino.
Recovering.
No, what can you make for our team? On it, Chango. Heal today, Pastor. She could not cook. She could not carry anything. She could not do anything. But when you prayed for her, the power of God touched her, and she is healed.
Come on, celebrate that man's name.
Oh, John, no, back to
hallelujah. God bless you, Mama.
No, ba, me de go, Mama.
And she's going to continue being strong.
Ah, don't make a better matter.
Yes, quickly.
This gentleman is hearing after 15 years.
Woman, ire puru yapa yaba tininge mwangapa arabi.
Wait, give her the mic.
Auntie,
give her the mic.
Me in a microphone.
Give her the mic.
Me in a microphone.
Tell us.
Praise the Lord. This is the child of my brother. For 15 years, she started saying, Auntie, my ears are popped open. For 15 years. Come on!
There is power in your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift a voice to pray, it's you that I see.
He says, Auntie, my ears are hearing. What is it you know?
You don't think I know.
She is hearing today.
You're hearing me?
Yes. You...
Glory! Glory! God is good.
Yes.
I had a striking pain by my side for about 6 or 7 years.
No,
waiting on God to heal. The spirit has told me I've gotten healed and I feel the pain no longer exists.
It is done. It is done.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Boy, Rolaba.
Back pain and knee pain for 7 years.
Praise God.
Listen. What has God done for her?
This lady,
huh?
Demonic oppression over her life.
And no,
totally delivered.
Praise God.
You're
free.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
This is the mother of
the and no,
she's been blind for 2 years.
No, why at all? She could not see. She could not see.
For how many?
For two.
2 years.
For 2 years, apostle.
There is power in your name.
Wait, now we can see.
He can
see.
He can see.
Okay. He's also seeing.
Tell him to follow me.
Follow me.
Now if you're there,
I think you know.
And you want to receive this man. You want to receive this man as your Lord and Savior. I want you to repeat this word after me.
I
want to
be a
Lord Jesus. Tonight, I receive you as my Lord and Savior. I believe that you died for my sins and were raised for my glory. Tonight, you're my Lord. Amen.
Amen.
The message you have just heard was brought to you by Phaneroo Ministries International. For more information, contact us on telephone number 041-466-4291 or email us at phaneroocampala@gmail.com. You can also find us on the web at www.phaneroo.org. Or better still, feel free to join us every Thursday for our weekly fellowship at Uma Multipurpose Hall from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. You can also catch the live stream at livestream.com/Phaneroo. Phaneroo, make manifest.